Hello, everybody, and Happy New Year. I'm Walter Benasiak, and this is Top 5. We're starting off 2018 with tried and true 90s Nickelodeon, specifically the game shows from Nick's golden age.
Hey!
Who are you?
The name's Sandy.
Okay. What do you want, Sandy?
You said you were gonna do this list last year.
I know, we just got caught up with Star Wars month in December, but that's why I'm doing it now.
Star Wars sucks! You suck.
Alright, I'm gonna get the list started.
Yeah! Do that!
This will complete my 90s Nickelodeon trilogy.
Last year, we covered the best 90s Nicktoons and live-action shows. While we'll still probably go over individual series from this time period in Nick's history, the three main aspects of the channel I wanted to talk about were Nicktoons, live-action series, and the game shows. These game shows were just as big a part of Nick's identity, stretching all the way back to the 80s. They involved the kids who watched the channel, and it was always great to see ourselves reflected in the contestants playing the games. There are very few things I wanted more in life than to be a contestant on one of these shows. They looked like so much fun. Alas, I never did make it to Nickelodeon Studios in Orlando, Florida, but the memories of these shows and the atmosphere of pure joy that surrounded them are as palpable today as they were when I watched them initially. There were a lot of these programs on Nick at the time, but which were the very best ones? Let's find out.
These are the top 5 best 90s Nickelodeon game shows.
Number 5.
Figure it out.
They brought this back in 2012, but the original was a nice, weird little game show filled with slime.
Figure It Out was hosted by Summer Sanders and featured panelists from other Nickelodeon shows. Kids with hidden talents competed as contestants as the celebrity panel attempted to guess the words that describe their talent on a big display board called Bill the Answer Head. For every one of these 3 single-minute rounds the panelists didn't guess the contestant's talent, he or she would walk away with a prize.
There were plenty of little rules within that game that made it unique.
In the second round, they would implement a secret slime action. This would be anything from talking to asking the contestant a specific question. If any of the panelists unknowingly performed the secret slime action, they'd get slimed with that glorious green goop. They'd also send out unique clues and the charade brigade to help the panelists throughout the game. It was cool to see these Nick stars outside of how we usually saw them. The show was a fun and loose game that was easy to watch. Most of the time.
I know how to do one.
Nobody cares.
What?
Can I have a piece of cheese, please?
Later. We'll do it later.
The kids' talents also weren't always so special.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Stoddard from New York, and I can bite cheese into the shapes of states.
But overall, it was fun and creative. Not nearly as good as the other entries on this list, but you could always count on Figure It Out for a funny, watchable experience.
Moving on to number 4.
The secret slime action is ending the show.
Number 4.
Kid Me plus video games? Yeah, this was a must watch whenever I caught it.
Nick Arcade was hosted by Phil Moore and featured 2 sets of 2-person teams going head to head. They implemented topical questions and video games into the early rounds, with the winning team entering the video zone. There, they would face off against the virtual video game wizard of the day for a chance at the grand prize.
Out of all the game shows in this video, this is the one that I'm least familiar with.
It only ran for 2 seasons in the early 90s and reruns until 1997. For some reason, I was just never around when it was on though. Whenever I did see it, I got very excited because it was so rare for me to catch a glimpse of. The early rounds were pretty cool with the kids playing arcade games and whatnot, but what made this show so great was that you could actually go inside a video game in the final round.
Alright. Ooh, steam in the face, but he got the first circuit breaker. Ooh, got zapped in the head. Right, everything is frozen. He's gonna have to kinda haul it across the bridge. Bam, 2 down, 3 power units left.
Yeah, the video zone was just the best. I wish the whole show was like that. It made it stand out from other Nick game shows and is the main reason why it's remembered so fondly. Nowadays, that effect isn't so special, but back then, and to a kid, it seemed like reality and virtual reality collided for our viewing pleasure.
This show might do great with a modern reboot. What do you think?
Number 3.
It's Family Double Dare!
host of Family Double Dare, Mark Summers!
Hi there! Nice to see you.
I know, this is technically an 80s show, but it aired until 93, so I'm counting it.
Super Sloppy Double Dare, Family Double Dare, whatever incarnation you're most familiar with, this was the staple of Nickelodeon game shows for years. It featured two teams answering trivia questions that a lot of the time led to physical challenges. Eventually, the team with the most money would try their luck at the final challenge obstacle course. It was always messy, but we loved it. Double Dare is remembered well among those who tuned in to see it.
Double Dare had bar none the best game show host in channel history.
Mark Summers was, and is still, the man. I really enjoyed his banter with the contestants and camaraderie he had with the other on-screen regulars. He was just a joy. Also loved him on What Would You Do?
Now, Greg, you have the most interesting career change. You started off doing what?
I was a missionary in Japan. Now I buy weapons of mass destruction for the U.S. government.
The show did live on after its final episode aired in 1993. It was resurrected as Double Dare 2000 at the turn of the century, and even had a reunion with the original cast in 2016. There are rumors floating around that the show could still be resurrected on Nick at Night with adult contestants.
I don't know about you, but I'd watch that in a second.
Number 2.
Do you have it?
Do you have it?
Guts was hosted by Mike O'Malley and refereed by Maura Quirk. It was an action sports competition show that featured three young athletes facing off in several extreme challenges. They would accumulate points until the finale, a race up a mountain called the Aggro Crag. For the fourth season, it was renamed Global Guts and included athletes from all over the world. The show was also briefly resurrected as My Family's Got Guts and aired from 2008 to 2009.
This is definitely one of those shows I was dying to get on.
Guts had a catchy theme song, a good host, great events, and of course...
The Aggro Crag, where almost anything can happen. Our players will get a lot of surprises as they make their way up that mountain. Snowstorms, smoke, slime, water in their eyes, a whole bunch of actuators to hit falling rocks.
Yeah, that thing was badass. The Aggro Crag kept evolving as the seasons went on, and it was always fun seeing these kids compete. The thing about Guts was that it was kind of dangerous. I'm sure the kids and their parents knew the risks, but man, it could get pretty brutal.
It's like Ty May at first place, she's going for second place, Poison, and falls, and falls, and falls!
But honestly, that made me love it more. This show was no joke.
And the number one best 90s Nickelodeon game show is...
Legends of the Hidden Temple!
Red Jaguars for life.
Legends of the Hidden Temple was an action-adventure game show that combined history, obstacles, and challenges to create something very unique. A giant talking head named Olmec was the keeper of the legendary temple and provided many of the facts about what the contestants were playing for. Kirk Fogg hosted the show in addition to being the team's guide.
Now!
This wasn't just my favorite Nick game show. This was one of my favorite Nick shows, period.
It had the best of Guts and added a cool theme with different team names to claim as your favorite. The Red Jaguars, Orange Iguanas, Green Monkeys, Purple Parrots, Silver Snakes, and Blue Barracudas competed on the show for the right to enter Olmec's temple and retrieve that episode's precious historical item. During the temple run, several temple guards waited in the wings to capture the players unless you had a full pendant of life, which was earned in the previous games. From the theme song to the set, this show stood out as something really remarkable. It's no wonder that its popularity has endured. In 2016, the show was made into a TV movie that had many elements from the original in it, including host Kirk Fogg himself.
The legend continues, right?
These game shows capped off the trifecta that included Nicktoons and live-action series on 90s Nickelodeon. Without them, it just wouldn't have been the same. My inner child is still holding out hope to one day enter Olmec's temple or even climb the Aggro Crag. Well, a guy can dream. Over on my personal channel, you can check out my top 5 favorite films from 2017 and a Jumanji 95 versus Jumanji 17 comparison video going up soon. So head on over for more content.
I want to hear what you guys think. What is your favorite 90s Nickelodeon game show? What do you want me to cover next on this show? leave a comment, and let me know. To keep in touch, like my Facebook page, facebook.com/awesomewalterb, or follow along on Twitter to take part in more polls about what may be covered in the future. Come back next week for a brand new episode of Top 5. Ugh.